In our previous videos, we concluded that we use the dimension of a physical quantity to check for the consistency of equations, and we can also use it to derive equations. So in one of our previous videos, still, we explored on how we use dimensional analysis to check for consistency of equations. In this video, we are going to concern ourselves with how we use this dimensional analysis to derive equations. This is Kisembo Academy, and thanks for tuning in. To use dimensions of a physical quantity to derive equations, we use this method of dimensional analysis to derive the equations only and only if we have an idea about the factors upon which a given quantity depends on. For example, given this question of ours, we are having the quantity t, which we are calling the periodic time. And according to the question, we have an idea about what this quantity depends on. It's going to depend on length, which is L. It's depending on mass, M, and acceleration due to gravity. The question goes that consider the oscillation of a single pendulum. The period T, which is that, may depend on mass M, which is that, times the length L, which is that, and acceleration due to gravity, G. Find the values of X, Y, and Z. Of course, if you're finding the values of X, Y, and Z, hence, you are finding the formula. Now, first of all, we will begin the working by removing that proportionality sign. When we remove the proportionality sign to introduce equal signs here, it means we are going to introduce a constant of proportionality, and that constant of proportionality is what we are calling k here. That t is going to be equal to k times l to the power x times m to the power y times g to the power z. So we shall look at our left-hand side. The dimensions on our left-hand side, in our left-hand side we have periodic time t. So on our left-hand side it's going to be t, capital T. Those are the dimensions of on our left-hand side. So we'll get to look at our right-hand side. On our right-hand side, which is this, we are having k, which is a constant. And we know that constants are dimensionless, so it is going to, it won't have the signs. It won't have any dimensions, times L. Now, L is the length to the power x, L to the power x, times M, which is the mass to the power y, mass is capital M, times the dimensions of gravity to the power z. Now we know that the dimensions of L are capital L to the power x times the dimensions of m. This is mass according to our question. So it is mass m to the power y. Multiply that by gravity, acceleration due to gravity. The dimensions for acceleration are lt to the power negative 2. That's all to the power z. So in our next step, we are going to simplify this further. So it is L to the power X times M to the power Y times L to the power Z times T to the power negative 2Z. Now if you realize this, we are having this. We can join this and that. So joining that and to that, we realize that on our right hand side, we remain with K, which is the constant, times L. Now law of indices, L times L, same base. We add the power, so it's going to be x plus z times m to the power y, which is that, times t to the power negative z, which is that. So this is our right hand side, and our left hand side is right there. So from there we proceed with our working, and we shall say that our right hand side, which is k into l to the power x plus z times m, which is to the power y, times t to the power negative 2z, is going to be equal to, this is our right hand side, it's going to be equal to our left hand side, which is t. So for us to be able to get these values of x, y, and z, we are going to equate the powers on both sides to get these values. So we shall start with the quantities. We have L this side and L that side. We look at the powers of L this side. The powers of L this side are x plus z. So we shall say x plus z is going to be equal to the powers of L this side. Now this side we do not have any L, so it's equal to 0. So that's equation 1. Then we have m, the powers of m. Now the powers of m this side, we have y. Y is going to be equal to the powers of m this side we do not have m, so it is equal to 0. Then we have t. The powers of t this side is negative 2z, so we have negative 2z is equal to the powers of t this side here, t is to the power 1, so it's equal to 1. This is equation 2, this is equation 3. So we use these three equations to find the values of x, y, and z. And from these equations, we already know that we've already found that y is equal to 0. So we already know that y is 0. Then you look at, if you come and look at this, we have negative 2z is equal to 1. Therefore, z is going to be negative a half. So y is 0, z is negative a half. Then we can get the value of x. X plus z is equal to 0. We know that z is negative a half, so it's going to be x minus a half is equal to 0. Therefore, x is going to be a half. So from what we've got, we see that our value of y is 0. So this is going to be k times l. L to the power x, x is a half, times m is y. Our value of m is, our value of its mass, our value of y is 0, m to the power 0, times our value of z. Our value of z is negative a half, so it's negative a half. So from there we shall formulate our equation. So it's going to become k times the value of l to the power half. We know that any power to the power 0 is 1, so that this is times 1, times g to the power negative a half, which is the same as 1 over g to the power half. So our equation will become, this is going to give us l to the power half over g to the power half, that is t is equal to k. And this is the same as saying the square root of l over g. And that is the equation.